Tim.
It's the morning star drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star drive, you know.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's Wednesday, April 27th. And this is the Morning Star Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and make sure to support us on Patreon. So what is happening on this wonderful Wednesday? We've got current news from around the world, realizing from the Tuesday Proverbs, and of course, every Wednesday we have Danny's Money. All right, everyone, how's it going? It is Wednesday. It is hump day in the middle of the week, and I hope you guys are looking forward to an amazing Wednesday service tonight. We got our head leaders and leaders preaching, so make sure that we spend some time today praying for our leaders to give a very powerful delivery of today's message. All right, super thankful for all of you joining us here on the Morning Star Drive. You could be doing a lot of tons of different things, listening to other things too. But I'm thankful here from the morning, from the get-go, we're listening to this Morning Star Drive, getting ourselves into the day, going over the word, you know, current news from around the world, a lot of different things. I hope you guys are really gaining from this. Thank you so much for all your comments. Keep commenting, guys. Comment, like, and it's not for the algorithm. It's mainly just to build a community. Remember, this is a members channel, so I'm not even thinking about like spreading the news of this channel because mainly only the members are really going to understand, you know, all the different contents and the word that comes from this channel anyways. So it's more about building the community. So I hope that all of us here in the English speaking world in Providence can build the community through the likes and the comments, like other people's comments, comments on other people's comments, whatever it is. This is a great place for us to start a new community. So today, once again, another episode of Danny's Money. Daniel Baker over there in Korea. We heard 2 weeks ago he has planned to come to Houston, which is kind of crazy because I'm here right now. Well, the week that he announced that he's going to Houston was the week, last Wednesday, was the week that I was going to Houston. So it's kind of like a huge coincidence, but I had a good talk with him, and also, you know, I just found out recently, so I'm really, really even more thankful that he came up with today's podcast segment, because his grandfather just passed away, so our condolences and prayers goes out to the Baker family, all right? So, what did I do last night? Last night, you know, I'm here having a great vacation over here in Houston, and it wasn't sport. Oh, you know what? I was supposed to go to paintball, but it started raining. So we postponed the paintball to Thursday. And instead, yesterday we just went out and then like kind of, I don't know, like spontaneous. We're like, hey, let's go karaoke. So like, you know, just a bunch of us going to karaoke. I was with the Sumney boys too. And they were nuts. Like, you know, from the first song. I forget, what was the first song? I don't even remember what the first song was. But up and dancing and just, it was just an amazing time. That's why my voice is kind of hoarse right now, because I'm just singing Backstreet Boys, Aladdin, A Whole New World. Like, you know, I'm singing my, you know, my go-to songs. I was talking with a friend this morning, and we were all thinking about, man, you know, way back in the days, the songs that we used to sing or listen to when we're like in high school and such, those lyrics are terrible. Like, they're just terrible lyrics. And like, we started repeating some of the sentences from the songs that we used to sing, and we're like, wow, it is so bad back then. And you know, this is kind of weird because like my generation, we kind of like pride ourselves on like it's like so much better. Like our music was so much better. But when we really look at some of the songs, it's terrible. Like there's some really, really, I can't even repeat some of the lyrics that I used to sing. But when you look at it now, it's like, yeah, now was bad, but it wasn't that good back then anyway. So it's kind of like a reflection. When we listen to some of these songs, we're like, what? But then we're like, wait a second. The songs we had were just as bad. But that was kind of like an interesting revelation we had from yesterday and today. Tomorrow we do have a new video on Espresso with Sky, so go ahead, check that out. It's going to be the debate between faith versus works, and it's great because it has to do with this week's message and last week's about being saved by grace, like how much grace we've received and what we need to pay it back. And, you know, of course, in Providence, it's about the grace that saves us, right? And once we're saved and believed, and then we repay back that grace with our works, right? By doing and being obedient to Christ, right? So it's not the works that save us. It's the works that are basically repaying, right? Repaying what the Lord has given to us. Either way, so it's going to be a great video. Go ahead, share it with your newcomers. You can watch it yourself. Look at the logic and reasoning behind it too, okay? And of course, this week, there was no Sunday edition, but I will have a couple of them getting ready to go out for the next couple of weeks going out. This is actually the first time I've ever missed the Sunday edition in this entire 2 years. So I feel pretty bad that I missed it. So I'm like, oh, should I put two for next week? But I'm like, nah. You know, I can't really fret on it too much. And I'm going to be honest, like some people might say to me like, hey, don't worry, you deserve it. And the answer actually is, you know, what the real answer should be, like in my mind is like, hey, you knew you were coming to your last video. You should have prepared earlier. I'm like, yeah, you know, that's what the big responsible person would do. So I'm going to make sure this is the last time that I ever skip or miss a Sunday edition. But next week, we will have a new one coming out. Okay. So let's get into some music from member artists from around the world. We got some great artists in Providence, and they're putting out really good quality stuff. Today, our feature artist of the day is going to be AG from Japan, and he's just got great, like, dance, EDM, trance, and we're going to play Love is Eternal, the trance mix to that, so you guys, I know you guys really like this one, and then after that, we'll have Xeniac from the Paper Music Associates in Korea. That song's going to be Plutonium. And last but not least, you know, because I've been hanging out with the Somni Boys a lot, we're going to listen to Somni Boys from America with their latest song, Rise Up, all right? So I hope that everyone, as we're praying all these conditions, make sure you keep all these member artists in your prayers.
Rise up to the challenge, armed with the word and action. Belt to the truth, fasten, shield of faith in one hand. Sword of spirit, I'm slaying, no mercy, I'm praying. Everyone thinks I lost, but now I'm turning super saiyan. I gotta be new, gotta be great, I only gotta win this thing. Fix the mistakes, fix who I am, all I wanna do is change. Gotta be brave, gotta be tough, no more time for delaying. It's just training, training, all those times of pain. Off, pushing my limits, only with God. I'm trying to be better, I'm trying to feel God. Enemies watching, they want you to fall. But you have to be better, you have to give it your all. Every day I make myself, but I know it's not easy. This is the life I chose and I know my spirit's breathing. The battle has only begun and I may take damage. But if I fall, I only know how to do one thing, one thing. Rise up to the challenge, armed with the word in action. Belt to the truth, fastened, shield of faith in one hand. Sword of spirit, I'm slaying, no mercy, I'm praying. Everyone thinks I lost, but now I'm turning super saiyan. I'm Goku turning super saiyan, I'm charged up and I'm playing. On the mount like Sana, I connect with God like Wi-Fi. Receive the word, always praying, spiritual path where I'm staying. Everyone thinks I lost, but I'm always with him, so you know I'm prevailing. Protecting myself from Satan, armed with the truth, now my angels will shoot like. Now I'm at my truest form, I'm trying to really be the greatest. The power level can't contain it, my energy is never draining. Look how far we have made it, unlocking levels, never hesitated. There's no trying, you just do it or don't, so fix your thoughts instead. Everybody makes mistakes, just gotta take notes, can't afford to do it again. Life is so easy, if you just do what is right and just follow what's real. Victory comes through skill, gotta stay on course, time to kill. Rise and shine, dig into the past and then forget. Ground of the Lord, by your side, put your hand, dry your eyes. Trust in the Lord every night and day. He'll never let you go, don't fall away. Be bold, be brave, and with all your heart, love the Lord to the end of time. Rise up to the challenge, armed with the word in action. Held to the truth, fasten, shield of faith in one hand. Sword of spirit, I'm slaying, no mercy, I'm praying. Everyone thinks I lost, but I'm turning super saiyan.
And there it is. That is the Sumney Boys from America with their latest single that just dropped last week. That song is Rise Up. And that is kind of the remix and paying homage to the original Rise Up song. And like I said, that last rap in this song is kind of like part of it is the rap that I made when we sang the song originally too. You know, I don't know where I can find the original song for this, but I'll look for it. It's somewhere out there. The one in Korean, I'm gonna find it so that we can play both of them at the same time side by side, and then you'd be like, oh, okay, this is very close to the original. Before that was Xeniac from the Paper Music Associates in Korea with Plutonium, and of course our featured artist of the day, that is AG from Japan with Love is Eternal, and that is the trance mix. Okay, so let's get into some current news going on around the world. And more than anything else, this is something, like I say, every single day. If anything, when Sunseem tells us to watch TV, well, he doesn't tell us to watch TV, but he's like, if you're going to watch TV, watch the news and, you know, and watch the world events. And right now, there are a ton of things going on around the world, and why it's so important, especially now as we have our prayer condition. Sunseem said, you know, we should pray about the Russia-Ukraine war, knowing the situation well. And the only way we're going to know it well is if we watch the news and hear what's happening each and every day, okay? And so the three reasons, number one, we just said it, is to be able to know what's going on in the world. Number two, Sunseem said that through the world news, you can see what God is doing in the world. So that's really important. And last but not least, with the things that are terrible that go on, we're able to comfort God's heart with the things that are just really bad, right? So I hope it's something that we're gaining something when it comes to the current news from around the world. So let's start it off with the Russia-Ukraine situation. And what have we missed over the last 24 hours? So first thing, big news is Germany's government has authorized the supply of about 50 anti-aircraft tanks to Ukraine in a major policy shift. So Berlin's decision comes as the U.S. and its allies meet at an airbase in Germany to pledge more weapons for Ukraine. And Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov warned NATO against supplying military aid to Ukraine, saying there was a risk of the conflict escalating into World War 3. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres has called for a ceasefire in Ukraine ahead of talks with Russia's Vladimir Putin later. Guterres describes discussions with Lavrov as frank, but insists he is visiting Moscow as a messenger of peace. And lastly, there's like fresh explosions that have been reported in the Moldovan breakaway region of Transnistria, which neighbors Ukraine. So, you know, let's get into that. Transnistria, like this Moldovan area. Why is this important and why does it matter? Well, these kind of mysterious explosions in Transnistria, a breakaway Russian-controlled territory in Moldova, have raised fears that the Ukraine conflict may be spreading. So Russia has about 1,500 troops based in Transnistria, which borders on Ukraine and broke away from Moldova in a brief war in 1992. So if Russia reinforces Transnistria, it could enable its forces to move on Odessa, a strategically important port city from the west. And its push on the city from the east was blocked by Ukrainian troops. So on Friday, a top Russian general, Rustam Minnikhaev, said control over the south of Ukraine is another way out to Transnistria, where there are also cases of oppression of the Russian-speaking population. So President Putin has pledged to protect ethnic Russians in ex-Soviet republics, and that was his argument for invading Ukraine. So Moldova was formerly Soviet Moldavia. Okay, and Moldova is not in NATO or the EU. It is one of Europe's poorest countries and home to many ethnic Ukrainians. Also, what happened with Germany? Like, one thing we do need to know, if Germany sending 50 anti-aircraft tanks to Ukraine, why is that kind of important? Because Germany's policy was never to get into this. They're not going to send any weapons and such. However, there's a major policy shift and by the German government, which authorized the supply of these Gepard Flankpanzer anti-aircraft tanks. So this is really interesting that they actually changed policy. So they were held in storage for the past decade, and they'll get technical upgrades before being shipped to the Ukraine. And Germany, their policy had long had no shipping of heavy weaponry to conflict zones, but its government has come under increasing pressure to provide more help to Kyiv. So making the announcement, the country's defense minister, Christine Lambrecht, said Germany would look into all possibilities how they can further support Ukraine in its courageous and important fight for freedom and for peace. Right, so that's kind of the news kind of going around with this Russia-Ukraine crisis. Let's move over to South America. And in South America, El Salvador. Interesting thing. It's kind of like the Philippines before, but El Salvador has its anti-gang measures and is considered a success as 17,000 people have now been held. So El Salvador's defense minister has praised the extension by Congress of emergency measures, which he says are having a positive effect in the battle against rampant gang violence. Rene Moreno said that more than 17,000 suspected gang members had been arrested since the state of emergency was declared a month ago. And on Sunday, Congress extended the measure by another 30 days. And it came into force on March 2017 after 62 people were murdered in one day. So it's definitely emergency, right? The emergency measures have been controversial as they limit some constitutional rights, such as allowing the security forces to arrest suspects without a warrant. The sentences for convicted gang members have also been raised to a maximum of 45 years in jail. And Defense Minister Moreno said that crimes such as extortion had dropped since the emergency measures were introduced. And he added that the honest population is very satisfied with the work they're doing against gangs, but didn't say if any polls had been carried out which supported his statement. So rights advocates have been highly critical of the mass arrests carried out in the past month. The UN's Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights warned earlier this month that thousands of Salvadorians had been detained without an arrest warrant and that some had been reported being subjected to cruel, inhumane or degrading treatment. So the spokesperson for the Human Rights Commission, Liz Throssell, said that changes to El Salvador's criminal procedure also meant that criminal trials could now be held in absentia in the case of alleged gang members or presided over by so-called faceless judges whose identity remained confidential. Mr. Moreno said on Monday that those arrested who were found to have no links to gangs would be freed. But rights groups like Human Rights Watch have condemned tweets by the Salvadorian police, which showed suspects being arrested and said that the government's strategy seems to be first arrest, then tweet, and investigate later. So homicide figures Good thing is, homicide figures have been dropping since Nayib Bukele was elected president in 2019. The 40-year-old campaigned on a promise to tackle rampant gang violence and political corruption. So he's young. He's like 3-4 years younger than me, and he's doing, you know, he's a president of a country, right? In 2021, El Salvador registered 1,140 murders, and compared to a high of 6,656 in 2015. So that number has gone down, right? Like 5,000, over 5,500, right, in a single year. But there has been a rise in homicides since the beginning of this year, with March 26 standing out as having been the most deadly day in decades. Okay, so that is happening in El Salvador at the moment. What is the right thing to do? You know, we're just not there. We don't have enough information. All we can go by is, you know, what we can hear from this situation. Last but not least, let's get into North Korea. So Kim Jong-un vows to step up nuclear weapons program. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un made a defiant speech at a military parade on Monday night, vowing to ramp up the country's nuclear arsenal. The parade, to mark the armed forces' founding anniversary, also displayed banned ICBMs, intercontinental ballistic missiles. In March, North Korea tested its largest known ICBM for the first time since 2017, and it sparked wide condemnation from the international community. The U.S. also imposed several sanctions on the country after the test. ICBMs, designed for nuclear arms delivery, extend North Korea's strike range as far as the U.S. mainland. Now, the parade also featured submarine-launched ballistic missiles in addition to hypersonic missiles. However, Mr. Kim has been undeterred by the condemnation so far, and in his speech he said, "We will continue to take steps to strengthen and develop our nation's nuclear capabilities at the fastest pace," he said, adding that their nuclear forces must be ready to be exercised anytime, according to a report by the official Korean Central News Agency. You know, North Korea's nuclear weapons were fundamentally a deterrence tool against war, but could be used for other means, he said, echoing previous rhetoric that the country would strike back if attacked. So parade pictures released by state media show that the Hwasong-17 was among the weapons displayed at the parade. North Korea claimed to have test-fired the massive ICBM for the first time in March. South Korean experts, they have questioned the success of the test launch, but typically Pyongyang showcases its new weapons at its military parades, which often feature long processions of tanks, artillery, and soldiers. Monday's military parade was closely watched as North Korea has tested several missiles this year, heightening tensions on the peninsula. And of course, in addition, satellite images from have shown North Korea firing up activity at its nuclear testing facility in I'm not sure how to pronounce this, but I think it's like Punggye-ri in March, stoking fears the country would resume testing nuclear weapons and long-range missiles. So the recent election of South Korea's new president, Yoon Suk-yeol, who has voiced a harsher line on North Korea's actions, has frayed relations. South Korean Defense Minister Seo-uk earlier this month said the South had the capacity to strike the North's missile launch points, sparking a furious reaction from Pyongyang. So this is what's happening right now. Let's see what's going on. And of course, the U.S. is always involved when it comes to South Korea and North Korea. So let's see what happens in here. And let's see what President Biden prioritizes in their relations with South Korea and Japan. And, you know, so far, Biden has thrown his support to the South, especially the outgoing President Moon Jae-in, to smooth relations between the two countries. Okay, so that is the top three news going on around the world. Hope it helps you guys out with your prayers and what you guys should be praying about. And it'll be something that we can really be able to, you know, cry out to God, especially when it comes to these really, really dangerous things. Okay, so let's get into some sporting news. Top three sporting news of the day. We had the NBA playoffs going on right now. Really exciting, but just unbelievable. I was out for dinner with some members last night, and the game was on TV, and Boston defeats Brooklyn 116-112, and now they have been swept. Brooklyn's been swept with Durant and Irving, 4-0. Jason Tatum, he fouls out, but he has 29 points, but he fouled out in the fourth quarter, which means they had like 10 minutes without their best player, and they still couldn't beat them. Kevin Durant had 39 points, but he was 13 of 31 shooting, so that's, you know, he's like shooting at like 35%. Kyrie Irving, only took 13 shots. He had 20 points, but he only took 13 shots. They weren't as involved as they should have been. Toronto Raptors, another good game. 103-88 over the Philadelphia 76ers. Now the series is at 3-2. Philadelphia can end it on their home. Oh, no, they lost on their home court, so they're going back to Toronto. Harden and Embiid struggle, combining for only 35 points. Luka Doncic back for the Dallas Mavericks. They just destroyed the Utah Jazz 102-77. That series is now 3-2 for Dallas, and Luka Doncic with 33 points, 13 rebounds, and 5 assists. In soccer news, from tonight we start the Champions League semifinals, and it's going to be Man City versus Real Madrid. And of course, Man City is considered the better team, but Real Madrid has been on a very big hot streak. So we'll report about this tomorrow. And then the day after, we're going to see Liverpool versus Villarreal. Villarreal is kind of interesting because they're not really a strong team, right? But they came out into the semifinals. It's their first semifinals since 2006. But Liverpool seems to be the hot team because they've only lost once since December 28th, which means in 4 months of action, they've lost once, which is quite crazy. So they are currently the powerhouse. They are in the FA Cup finals, and that's coming this weekend. They already won this other trophy. If they win the Champions League and the Premier League, that will be the quadruple, the quad, and which is like, you know, very basically impossible to get. But they could be the first team who has a chance to do it, right? In Major League Baseball action, you know, I'm not really into Major League Baseball because, you know, they had that strike, which makes us like even more disinterested in baseball. But just a couple of games on the slate because NHL, I can't report anymore because the Vancouver Canucks are out of the playoffs. But the Dodgers, right? LA Dodgers defeat the Arizona Diamondbacks 4-0. Dodgers are top of the National League West. The Angels defeat the Cleveland Guardians 3-0. Texas defeats Houston 6-2. The New York Mets, surprisingly, top of the National League East. They defeat the St. Louis Cardinals 5-2. And St. Louis, I believe, is also St. Louis is also on top of the National League West, I believe. I think. Is it the Midwest? I'm not sure where it is, right? But they're on top of one of the divisions too. Toronto Blue Jays, the only Canadian team in Major League Baseball, defeat the Boston Red Sox 6-2. And yes, Toronto is top of the American League East. So that's a good, you know, that's great for them and for Canada. Okay. Philadelphia, the Phillies defeat Colorado Rockies 8-2, and San Francisco Giants defeat the Milwaukee Brewers 4-2. All right, so that is the top three news in sports and current news around the world, which means it's the golden time. Yeah, it is the golden time, a time of praise and worship to the Holy Trinity. And I hope it's something that all you guys are really enjoying, a time that we can just, you know, praise, whether in your car, at home, cleaning, you know, washing, cooking, whatever it is. You know, this is a time that we can just really spend together in praise and worship, preparing our hearts for the word study today. So we're going to start off with this one. I really, really like this song, The Fulfillment of Hope. It's got a very, very good flow in the song. And then we'll go into The Sail of Life, another old school one. And then we'll end things off with I Believe, which is three old school songs. So I hope you guys enjoy this. Everyone, as one body of the Morningstar Drive, let's spend this time giving praise, honor, and glory to the Holy Trinity.
Think of him as a lamb, while calling on the Lord. as I am walking on this road that leads to the city of gold, the Lord's sail is planted in my center, and on the Lord's wings I will rapture higher. I believe that the will has been fulfilled. I believe that my spirit rose with Him. I believe I'm living in the city of gold, and in this life I will always give thanks as I rise towards that place. With the condition of the Lord, God's dream finally came true. As for me, I'll walk this path unchanging. I'll do what I must, and I'll never turn back. I believe that the will has been fulfilled. I believe that my spirit rose.
Yes, oldie but a goodie. Hope you guys really enjoyed that time of praise and worship. Before that's the sail of life, and of course, the fulfillment of hope. Okay, so now that our hearts are more into that spiritual zone, let's get into the word study for today. And of course, every single Tuesday, Every single Wednesday, we are going over the Tuesday Proverbs. That's what I was trying to say. So every Wednesday, we go over the Tuesday Proverbs, kind of go a little bit more deeply into it. And once again, we have another 5 Proverbs from the Tuesday morning. So let's go over them one by one. Let's see how deep we can get into these. So let's start off with, number one says... Well, number one, I'm going to do number one and two together because they really connect, okay? So number one is people can see each other, but still they cannot understand each other's thoughts or shimjung. They can be weak. Their hearts can change numerous times, all right? So when I listen to this, it's kind of that predicament that all of us, you know, that every human being has, is we really, really don't know until someone tells us the truth. And when I mean someone tells us the truth is, there's a lot of times people don't even tell us what is really on their hearts and mind. It's true, right? Sometimes you just don't want to tell anyone. And we will never know until they finally tell us that this is what they were thinking. And all we can do is just guess. We guess from the subtle hints they give us through their expressions, their body language. But in the end, we're not really that sure. And when we look at this verse here, it kind of shows like the weakness of human beings or the level of human beings. We just can't see. we don't really know that well. And this is why a lot of us get burnt and disappointed at each other, is because, you know, we think a certain way, or we think people are thinking this or doing it for this intention or reason. But it's usually, like, not usually, but there are a lot of times when it's not the case. And we just feel like we got burned, or we feel like, oh, I thought it was different. Oh, I thought we were closer. Or I thought, oh, I thought we liked each other. Or I thought this and I thought that. And when you read this verse, it's so true. Even though we can see each other, and this is a thing where it connects to number two, is even though we see each other, and we put such a high emphasis on seeing, right? Seeing to believe. But it's so true. Looking at human beings, just because you see, doesn't mean it's true. Just because you see it in front of you, just because you hear the voice, people can lie, right? And on top of that, last sentence says, people are weak, and our hearts can change numerous times. And I'm sure all of us can look at ourselves in many different situations, and we're going to see that, yeah, we change our minds a lot. Like, haven't you guys ever had it where you really wanted to do something and you were so into it, but then by the time you're able to do it, you don't feel like doing it anymore. And your parents are like, what? We took you all the way over here because you said you wanted to do this. But then by the time it's that time, like, you know, you waited such a long time, you don't want to do it anymore. Right? I mean, like, I can think of times where people are mad at each other, and then people take sides, but then when the real situation comes together, that friend or that person who is on your side is not really on your side, and not on their side. It's just they're not as strong as they were before. People change all the time. And I think this is one of the, you know, this is the weakness of human beings, right? And the paradox is we can see, but we still have no clue. And it kind of gives us, showing you the importance of just because you see doesn't mean much, which leads and connects into number two, which says, on the other hand, right? So it's connecting. On the other hand, you can't see God. However, because he is mighty, he knows your shimjung completely, helps you with the things you need, and does his work. That's why God feels much more real than visible people. So here now is like, hey, you see people, and we put such an emphasis on seeing, being in this physical realm, but yet we get burned all the time, and we really don't know what's going on in people's thoughts and their hearts. And then on the other hand, if you look at the flip side, like, God, you can't see, and we complain about that. We complain, God, we don't see you. God, we don't hear you. God, oh my goodness, right? But he's almighty, which means he knows completely. That reminds me of the verse in, like, 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 7 that says, you know, human beings will misunderstand because they go by what they see, but not God, right? God sees everything because he sees your heart. He sees you from your core. And the part of this proverb that really strikes me the most is when, at the last sentence that says, God feels more real than visible people. That is something that we have to kind of, like, unpack, like, take in, digest, and unpack. He feels more real even though you can't see him. And I thought about that to myself as, like, oh, what does it mean to be more real? Because to be real, what does that mean? Like, oh, he's more real, but we can't even see him. But if you think about this, even when you look at all the people in your life right now, like, we go to church, we see hundreds of people, dozens of people, you know, 10 people, 20, 30, 40 people, right? We see people all the time. However, who is most real to us? It's the ones that are open and honest, the ones that know my heart, the ones that can empathize with me, the one that comforts me, the one that gives me the advice, or the one that listens. Like, this is the thing that makes someone more real. You can't be real just because you see, or else then, you know, look at all the people in this world. How many people actually feel real to you? Well, out of the 7 billion people in the world, just because you see them doesn't mean anything. What makes them less real is you just see them and that's it. But we put such a heavy emphasis on seeing when we realize, like, just from these two proverbs, just because you see, that's not everything. What's everything is, how real are they? Real meaning how much do they know my heart and my Shimjong? In anything else, I think one of the biggest things, like Sunseem was also talking about, he says, one of the things that people want is just people to understand them. So how real is someone who you can see but doesn't understand you? That doesn't make any sense, right? Yeah, that's not real. Real is, do people really understand your heart, right? And I think that is the thing that we have to understand, is what is real. Number three, it says, although invisible, God lets you feel his existence fully. He enables you to know that he exists through your hearts and thoughts. So, you know, a lot of people are thinking to themselves like, oh, well, how do I know God exists? I can't see him, right? This is all about seeing and believing. However, we can, through thoughts and your heart, God allows us to feel his existence, and not just feel it fully, right? So how can you feel someone that their existence is there fully just through your heart and thoughts? And I'm sure many of us have had this experience, right? Many of us had this experience where we're going through a difficult time, we're praying, and then at that moment when you pray, God help me, you can feel his presence come. And you feel it in your thoughts, you feel it in your heart, that warm feeling, God saying, I love you, or I am here. And just that feeling, you are already comforted by that moment, right? You're already comforted there. And I think the same thing happens even when it comes to people in the world. Sometimes you don't see the people you love, but you're comforted by them because you know that they're waiting for you. You know that you can call them anytime. You know that they're there for you, right? So I hope it's something that we can really understand at a much, much deeper level. And we'll be those that can take ourselves that will really understand to feel his existence fully. It has to happen through the hearts and the thoughts. Now, once again, this connects to number four. Since your spirit and soul are at a higher level than your body, God Almighty lets you see him through your spirit and soul, and consequently feel him with your body as well. And we see that if you really want to fully feel God's existence, right, it's through your heart and thoughts. But we have to realize, if you really, really want to feel and even see him through your spirit and soul, you have to reach the level of the spirit and soul. And we can see that in life, this is why a lot of people don't feel God, is because they're so physical. A lot of people out there, they're going to say they never felt God, this or that. However, when you look at their lives, there is nothing remotely even mental about it. It is purely physical, and they will never feel God, right? I'll tell you this. Whenever I teach three divisions, I tell people like, then how does a physical person realize about God? And the answer is, people begin to feel about God or reach out to God when they're in the worst of situations. Like, you know, they almost die or someone in their family dies. So the question is, but they're still physical, so how can they all of a sudden feel God? Well, when you think about it, if someone dies or you go through, your body goes through shock because someone dies and you're like, oh my gosh, this person's no longer in my life. That shock kind of like paralyzes your body, which means your emotion or your mind and your heart, your senses of your mind and heart become more heightened. And that's why you start to think about God more, because your body is so shocked. It's almost like your spirit is a child and the body is the adult, because you take care more of your body. Like, a lot of people are more physical, right? But imagine when the body gets really, really sick, then this little kid can get whatever they want because the parents are just too sick to do anything. And if you think about it in that analogy, in the same way, when your body goes through shock, almost died, someone in your family really close to you dies, and that physical body's no longer around you and you're just shocked, that's like the body getting sick. And then the child, which is this, the spirit, which is like this small child that's weak, all of a sudden becomes more powerful and becomes more prevalent, right? So the reason why is we need to be those that become much more spiritual than we were before. And when you become more spiritual, you feel God fully and you're able to see him through your spirit and soul, because that's the level we have to see God at, all right? That leads us into the last proverb for today. And today's last proverb, number five, is God listens to everything you say when you say what you need to say to him. That was like a tongue twister. God listens to everything you say when you say what you need to say to him. Right? He's always watching you. You just can't see him. Know this and feel him vividly, even if you can't see him. And this kind of seems like an accumulation of the last four Proverbs. God is invisible, but he's always watching you, and he's always waiting for you to listen to you. Right? The only difference is he's invisible. And if you understand this well, right, then you will see him vividly, right? Just because you can't see him doesn't mean you can't feel him, right? Even for me right now, when I think about my mom, I'm in Houston, but my mom's in Vancouver. I think about all the stuff my mom has done for me. Yeah, I feel her, right? Every time she comments on my YouTube channel, I feel it. Like that's the love my mom has. She's just supporting me, right? So when I look at this, I'm like, I can feel my mom too, even though she's not literally there. So I hope it's something that all of us will, recognize and, just if we can say amen to that promise, say everything you need to say because God is there listening. He's watching. And if we understand this, then we can reach the next level where we can actually see him and feel him without, with even with him being invisible, right? We see him through the eyes of the soul and the eyes of the spirit, all right? So that is the word study for today. I hope you guys were really able to spend a good time with these Proverbs. I think this is one thing that's really, really important, especially when it comes to our Proverbs every single pre-dawn, is we need very, very good, a good system where people can give good insight and be able to help people when it comes to the Proverbs. Because the Proverbs are hard. It's just like one sentence. And we really need to take as much as we can out from it, or else it becomes like just a sentence like, oh, that's deep. And you just say amen to it. But then after that, you're done with the Proverbs and you never read them again. So I really hope that we can continue to go over these Proverbs more and more each and every week. Okay. So that is the song of choice for today on this wonderful Wednesday. Now that was the word study. So let's get into the song of choice on this English Wednesday. We do have an awesome request today. And on this request, we have it's Chris Jansen over there in Minnesota, longtime listener, him and his wife, blessed family. And the song requested is from Depeche Mode. So the way back in the 80s, right? Depeche Mode with Personal Jesus.
Reach out, touch faith. Lift up the receiver of faith, you're a believer.
And there it is. That is Depeche Mode, Personal Jesus. That's a request from Chris Jansen over there in Minnesota. All right. So thank you so much for these requests. If you have any more, go ahead, leave in the comments below. Would love to hear your requests for your songs too. It could be praise. It could be the member artist. It could be the song of choice. It could be any of those things. Right. So thank you so much, which means we're going to get into the last segment for today. And of course, every single Wednesday, our last segment is going to be Daniel Baker, all the way over there in Korea, senior in high school, doing a segment every single week on financial freedom, his financial plan. Of course, all of us, we've heard this many times. Everyone, please welcome Danny Baker with Danny's Money.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to your favorite podcast segment, Danny's Money. As you all know, I like to present topics that I'm interested in that specific time. So these days, because of the end of the year capstone project in my school, my interest in entrepreneurship has heightened. As a part of my project, I'm researching around 50 famous entrepreneurs and their companies, while digging up advice for up-and-coming entrepreneurs. Therefore, for the next couple of weeks, I'm going to go over two successful entrepreneurs each episode. We're going to talk about their businesses, lifestyle, history, and the takeaways from their story. Today, we're going to talk about two entrepreneurs who are late bloomers. They started their business very late in their life, and they became very successful. This is going to be motivation for us who, even though at the start, you know, our businesses might not have succeeded, we can use these guys as an example for businesses who have succeeded very late in their life. The first successful entrepreneur we're going to talk about is Giorgio Armani. He is the most successful Italian fashion designer, and his net worth is estimated to be around $9.5 billion. He comes from a humble background by starting out as a salesman for a fashion department at his local department store. This is where he got a lot of experience and insight into the industry. From listening to his interviews, he didn't expect to end up in the fashion industry. He basically accidentally met people who dealt in fashion. He didn't attend fashion school, so he had to learn everything from scratch. After working for a big company for a while, he realized that he can have his own production company and his own brand, so he slipped away and created Armani. He designed Armani products with the sole goal of people being able to recognize a distinct style and say, "Oh, that's Armani." This meant that he had a style that he deviated little from. He clearly understood that he needed to create something that deviated from his competition, but will stand out and be recognized at the same time. Here is a nice quote I listened to from his interviews. "My job involves challenging yourself and saying, I did okay, but I can do better." That is the fundamental thing about entrepreneurship. You're creating an experience, but you can also improve it. You're saying, okay, I did okay, but how can I improve it? Here's another quote. "It is not up to me to recognize my talent for being able to impose myself on the world. It is up to what people, buyers, and at the end, consumers say." This is how you should evaluate your company. You should look by obtaining customer feedback and analyzing your results. That's if you're having a YouTube channel. You know, go into analytics, check and analyze your results. So what we can learn from Armani is that you want to have a product that is distinctive from other companies. However, you want to design that product so when people see your product, they can see your company. They can instantly recognize your company inside the style of your product. Also, we can learn that your innovation for your product, your service should never stop. Even though you might think it's good, you should make it great, make it perfect, or of course try to make it perfect, and you should never stop trying. The second successful entrepreneur we're going to talk about is Mary Kay Ash. She was a successful businesswoman in the United States, and she was the founder of Mary Kay Cosmetics. She founded a company worth $1.2 billion and had a personal net worth of $98 million. She started Mary Kay Cosmetics very late in her life. She only started off with the initial investment of $5,000. Now, how she found the product to sell, you know, the product that she's going to sell, was very interesting. She was an avid user of a formula of lipstick, which was very local, and it was like, I think it was a grandma, and she was just making lipstick. She never got it off the ground, and she bought the formulation in 1961 and made the lipstick pretty much famous. She mainly made it famous through her marketing plan. Let's see why her marketing plan was so successful. First off, she created an extremely close-knit and empowering company culture. She built the company's values on God and on the praise and uplifting of other women. She used the incentive of praise, diamonds, pink Cadillacs, to help workers become more confident in their selling abilities, which ultimately increased the sales. She also made cosmetics very exclusive. In the past, you only could buy Mary Kay Cosmetics at home parties designed to market the product. They will give free makeup sessions, then pitch the product. There was no way to get it off the shelf in a convenience store or a department store, which made Mary Kay able to charge more money for individual products because it was more exclusive. Here is a quote in her interview that really stuck with me. "If you make the most money in the world and have to count it yourself and lose your family in the process, it is not worth it." I 100% agree. Now, family, God, everything, yourself, all matters more than actually making money. So you have to get those in check, and then you can make money. And that's what I think the quote is meaning. So from Mary Kay Ash, we can realize a couple things. First off, having a really close-knit company culture really can help your company succeed. It can make people, you know, want to sell your product and not just be there for just to, you know, have or fill in hours so they can get money. Now, using incentives in your company might be a good way to improve your sales. Exclusivity of your product can be very important to increasing your sales, but also having the feeling that you are superior than your competition. I hope you guys enjoyed the different path I'm trying to take this podcast. I'm having a blast just listening to these interviews and making a lot of notes and really thinking about what kind of business I'm going to make in the future. Hope you guys have a nice day with the Lord and have a beautiful and safe next week. Peace out, guys. Bye-bye.
And there you have it. That is Daniel Baker over there in Korea with Danny's Money. Hope you guys really enjoyed that new episode and segment. And it's kind of cool because now we have a series of these segments coming out, and he's going over two entrepreneurs every single week. So I'm really, really looking forward to this. All right. So that is it and the end of today's Wednesday podcast. Hope you guys had an amazing and awesome time just like I have. And of course, everyone enjoy. Enjoy your Wednesday service tonight. And we'll see you guys again tomorrow on the Morning Star Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morning Star Drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the Morning Star Drive, you know. I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the Morning Star Drive, you know.